Hi, how are you?
It's her graduation. Ooh, baby graduating.
I'm shaking the table.
Okay,
not just shaking the table.
Yeah, so she's graduating, and I know I've been saying I'm gonna get her in front of this camera, y'all. So she is going to do her eye makeup.
I'm gonna be doing a smoky cat eye look. Excuse my nervousness, cause
I'm camera shy.
It's not right.
And I can't see what I look like from your point of view. So.
Yeah, so click the link above on my makeup page at Dolce Cosmetic Designs where you can see the full video to get ready with me for her graduation. But as she was doing her makeup, we went to talking and she was asking me about which generation I fall in, and I'm always going down a rabbit hole. So here's how that went. It was a pretty interesting discussion.
Mom, yeah, what's up? Question.
What's up?
You're a millennial, right?
I'm kind of in between. I don't know. Like I said, I'm that year.
You're a bridger.
Yeah, I'm like right in 1981, right when the millennials really started. So, and then I've hung out with a lot of older people, so I feel like I'm the generation before and the millennials.
The wooden stove generation.
I don't know if it's too far with the wooden stove, but yeah, I mean, mm-hmm. So yeah, like you say, I'm a bridger, I guess.
The petrified generation. Stone Age. You said you was hanging out with the older generation.
I grew up around a lot of older people and a hungry younger people, so she admits talking about some doggone Stone Age and wooden stove generation. But she's talking about, you know, like our grandparents more than likely born in the 40s who are part of the silent / traditionalists or the boomers, you know, like our parents are born in the 50s and so on, usually. But you know, they have this phrase, okay, boomers, you know, going around where they mock them, when basically it's just mocking people older than them they don't like, and they use millennials real derogatory like younger people they don't like. You know, you ain't even got to be part of the doggone boomers, and you just older than them, they just gonna say it, you know, a mess. But I mean, they got their points, you know, about certain things. So yeah, I can appreciate growing up around both generations, because you just learn a lot, you know. Especially, you know, back in the day, I remember a guy told me he stepped out in 85 and it just seemed like a different world, you know, which makes sense, because if you look at when the crack epidemic started, you see it was around 85, you know. So yeah, the world did look a lot different, you know, and you know, it was a time where you didn't have to lock your door and be outside, and the way we had fun was different, and there was a stronger sense of family unit and a stronger sense of community and all that, to where, you know, it just became real dangerous, and you know, all the gangs and all that stuff cropped up. Now, y'all 80s babies know y'all remember those PSA commercials in their classes now.
This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
So, yeah, it really affected the community as a whole, especially the Black community, where a lot of grandparents had to step in and start taking care of their grandbabies.
Forever and ever.
Yeah. 2-year-old Paige and 5-year-old Natavia aren't Denise's kids. They're her grandkids. Helping them out is an understatement. She's now taken on the full-time role of being their mother. Plus, Denise also has a 10-year-old daughter as well. Fortunately, she does have some help. Her husband, Leroy, has stepped up to take on all the daddy duties.
You ready? You ready?
My second oldest son, he was the first one to give me any grandchildren. He and his wife had a really rough relationship. There was a lot of drugs and alcohol involved, and there was physical violence. I had the kids move into my home with me. They would have the children locked in one of the spare bedrooms. From the outside, we'd have them locked in a bedroom. And I would just blow my stack. I was like, how can you treat the kids this way? It was just neglect. Then the parents separated. I got the legal custody of them, and I've had them ever since.
With their grandparents. According to the Drug Education Council, the opioid crisis is much to blame for that. The opioid epidemic is primarily taking over the lives of people in their late 20s, 30s, and 40s, the parenting generations, forcing the grandparents to step in and become parents all over again. Terry Smith gives me a tour of her home where she lives with her four-year-old granddaughter.
We've got grandparents that should be enjoying their lives. But instead, they are taking care of their kids' kids. What do you do when your kids drop their kids off on your doorstep and they keep getting up? They say they're gonna come back for the kids, but they don't come back for the kids. Now, more than likely, in this case, personally, I think they abandoned the kids. Don't know what happened, you know, I'm sure maybe for whatever reason, maybe the kids got strung out on drugs or something, or maybe just made some bad choices in life. It happens. But I think that's very selfish when children come home and bring their children so that their parents can take care of their children, which is not their parents' or the grandparents' responsibility. It's that daughter or that son's responsibility to take care of their kids. The grandparents did not lay up and get those kids. You did. They're your children. So why would you disrupt your parents' life and bring those kids on your parents?
So yeah, as you can see, it affects all races and all generations, because down from the crack epidemic ones to this new opiate stuff, you know. So yeah, when parents are strung out on hard drugs, living in squalor, neglecting and abusing their children, for sure it's a blessing when, you know, grandparents can step in, even though, you know, you need to raise your children, especially if you just want to go out and party and stuff like that. Now, don't be like that. Raise your children. And I don't think that grandparents should override, you know, if it's just a difference in lifestyles, because I know sometimes the generations have a certain differences in how they want to raise their children. If it's not where they are doing neglectful, abusive things that affect their children in a negative way, then yes, they deserve to raise their children in the best way that they see fit, without overstepping your boundaries as a grandparent or bullying and imposing your opinion, especially if they have not asked for it. You see what I'm saying now? Yes, be there to give sage advice if it is needed, especially if it is asked for. But yeah, all that bullying and doing the most, don't do that to your children who are trying to raise their own children. Especially if the grandparents ain't just been the parents of the year themselves. You feel what I'm saying? You know, some of that stuff be projection, so don't project especially your own mistakes onto your children, especially if they ain't doing all that. You know, let them folks raise their own children without backseat driving, especially if you're talking and wasn't showing yourself, because they could be trying to break generational things that were negative in the family line. So let them do them. You feel what I'm saying? But yeah, like I say, I've grown up around various ages, especially older people. So sometimes I seem, you know, young and youthful in spirit. My inner child is very much alive, but I also have the wisdom of age. And sometimes I seem a lot older than my age, you know, living in the country around older people. So sometimes when I sound and behave like that, that's the influence from that. So yeah, due to drugs and alcohol, I was affected where I had to live at a certain time with my grandparents and be raised. Also, I have younger sisters. You know, I think the youngest, a 10-year difference, and so therefore I was influenced by a younger generation as well. I hung with older people that I went to school with, as well as I'm around my children. So my daughter, you know, she's 18, so you know, you're going to know what about the younger stuff, too, when you got kids. They keep you young, too. I'm an interesting mix of a lot of things, and I do understand both sides, multiple generations, a.k.a. the bridge, I suppose. But regardless, I know there's the differences in the way generations have raised their children, and it should be a respect for each generation, you know, because they all, it seems like there's discrimination amongst generations, you know, where they stereotype each other. And so I think that that shouldn't exist, you know. But yeah, my daughter say I edit like I talk, y'all. I be rambling sometimes, but just was sharing it.
Okay.
So how you feel about y'all's generation?
Just massive crackheaded energy, you know.
Girl, okay. Girl, why you gotta be like that?
Because that's what my generation is.
Why?
I don't even need to answer that. The internet speaks for itself.
Oh,
Lord. TikTok.
Ugh. Well, I mean, some people be doing all right on TikTok. I mean, some be ridiculous in this.
Some. Okay. I'll let that slide since I know you don't have a TikTok, so.
I don't.
Yeah, it shows.
Whatever. I've seen some stuff on there. They be having it all on YouTube. Now that it's spilled over there. You showing these little TikTok videos.
Excuses. Excuses.
Whatever.
I do what I want.
But yeah.
It's your generation.
I know it's my generation.
See, I had to go see what she talking about because I thought she was just going extra hard on her generation. But because, you know, she talking about crackheaded generation. You know, I'm thinking about what I just showed y'all. And then when I'm thinking of TikTok, you know, I'm thinking about these little challenges, you know, little stank walk and all that stuff and those little makeup tutorials. And yeah, they be something. But, I mean, I can't say I would do all that, you know, but for some of those makeup tutorials, but some be cute. You know, that's what I was saying. Like, some people be doing all right on TikTok. What you mean? And it definitely is, you know, the little dance and stuff, and it has spilled over to YouTube. So we can see the stuff over there even without having a TikTok. But yeah, I guess you do have to kind of be on there to really just see. Because when I really went to go and look into it, I almost forgot about some of those dangerous challenges and ridiculousness. Because I do come from a time where social media wasn't really big, so I didn't grow up on social media. And now the younger generation do the most for likes, clout, and recognition, that they do kind of do some stuff that seem a little off in the head of crackhead energy. It's a not cause it, and it's bad when the person from your own generation say that. So I'll show y'all what she's talking about. I had to go and see. Yeah.
At first glance, it seems harmless. The banana peel challenge.
Patrick, banana peel! Don't!
What did you say?
This viral challenge is attracting thousands of clicks online.
Systematically sweeping products off of shelves. Even when these boys are confronted by employees, they appear utterly unfazed.
Can't ride a skateboard in the store. All right, let me have it, please.
Woo! This particular brand of mayhem creation seems to be a trend. People filming themselves, disrupting stores, and getting hundreds of thousands, even millions of views, and generating positive comments like LOL, so funny.
Trapped in LA gridlock, bored skateboarders have decided to hit the road, kickstarting a social media storm with this dangerous new trend. But what the police call reckless stunts, curiously advise that no one tries it. Still, many have, and many have failed.
A bizarre beauty trend blowing up on social media. Teens posting thousands of videos, transforming from this to this. The trend is starting off as a campaign for teens taking a stand against body shaming. But now this popular hashtag causing backlash online.
Shouldn't "don't judge me" mean you shouldn't care about what someone looks like at all? You shouldn't care about if they're hot or not.
Thousands criticizing it, saying the videos don't empower people, rather they mock them, doing more harm than good.
First glance, it seems harmless. Yet the latest viral challenge among teens, attracting millions of clicks, turned dangerous.
In most cases, sitting in a chair, but not always.
Now I just regret doing that challenge that day. I wanted to try it because I thought, it might be fun, but now I know it's not a good idea.
But Skylar's head hit the concrete, causing a brain aneurysm.
Trying to swallow a spoonful of cinnamon in 60 seconds with no water. There's been an alarming spike in the number of poisonings and ER visits.
Co-author of the study says taking the challenge could potentially cause long-term, even permanent lung damage.
If the cinnamon dust goes into lungs, it doesn't break down and it remains there long-term.
A boy ate 3 laundry pots in 1 bite. This is what happened to his lungs. JR is a 17-year-old boy presenting to the emergency room with emesis, respiratory distress, and somnolence. His mother, Jane, tells the admitting nurse that he had been vomiting, gagging, and struggling to breathe for at least 30 minutes. You see, JR had been participating in a contest with friends, the Forbidden Fruit Challenge, where contenders would take videos of themselves chewing on laundry detergent pods, and the person with the most social media likes and comments would win nothing. Clearly, this was for jokes and memes on behalf of teenagers. Most of them knew this was dangerous and were not actually going to put any laundry detergent in their mouths, but JR was determined. He was going to, as he told his friends, experience the greatness of laundry pod flavor and become internet famous.
A 12-year-old boy from Colorado died because of a trend on TikTok. Joshua was said to be a kind and creative boy that will be missed by many, but recently he lost his life because he participated in something called the Blackout Challenge. Most of these TikTok challenges aren't really challenges and are just like highly dangerous activities disguised as challenges because people are bored and I guess are looking for clout and are wanting to impress their friends. But in this challenge, it dictates that someone choke themselves, sometimes even to the point of passing out. But earlier, I recently just learned that this blackout challenge has gone by many different names, like the choking game, the pass out challenge, speed dreaming, the game of choking, the fainting game, the space monkey, and a whole bunch of other names. I know it sounds weird, but this is what it looks like.
This game involves individuals holding their breath or having their breathing restricted.
A lot of these challenges are just recycled and given new names, but it definitely is dangerous, and I'm not surprised that someone finally died. It's really sad. Joshua, the kid who died by this challenge, was found by his twin brother struggling to breathe in their bathroom. He tried to help him up before the responders arrived, and once the paramedics arrived, Joshua was taken to the hospital and put on life support for almost 3 weeks.
Aurora boy is fighting for his life after taking part in the so-called blackout challenge. Denver 7's Sloan Dickey talked with that boy's dad, who is sharing his story so other parents don't feel the same pain.
He want to be counted for, and he just pushes himself.
Joshua Haliasis is a hardworking 12-year-old.
He wants to be an actor. He had submit a video acting to Simbot app.
Sharing his achievements online, from acting to playing the guitar.
He worked so hard, he bought a guitar to play on it. He taught himself from YouTube.
To cooking.
He does work hard to impress me, impress everyone. He learned all that on YouTube. He knows all the spices and all those things that I don't know about.
Now he's in a fight for his life.
I never ever imagined this. He would do anything like this. He has plans, he has visions, he has a lot of things that he wants to do.
Last week, Joshua participated in the so-called Blackout Challenge, a trend on TikTok that encourages participants to choke themselves until they pass out.
I would never, ever imagine he would do such a thing, but the fact that he's exposed to ideas, like this kind of ideas, it's just crazy.
And Joshua's parents aren't alone. Kids across the country are giving in to this dangerous TikTok trend.
The kids especially, they don't know that fragile, how fragile they are.
A young boy in the fight of his life because of a social media challenge that went too far.
It could be a prank, whatever it is. This is not a joke. This is not a game to play with. You know, I am going through this pain, but I don't think anybody needs to go through this pain.
And this evening, family, friends, and neighbors of Joshua gathered at Children's Hospital for a prayer vigil. His parents say they wanted to get a story out for 2 reasons: to ask for prayers for their son and to tell parents across Colorado to talk with their kids. about this dangerous trend.
But unfortunately, after the 3 weeks, he didn't make it. And I know a lot of you parents out there who are watching right now don't understand why a lot of these games or challenges exist, but it's because, you know, young people like to around and we like to do dangerous things. There's a reason for why some, like, people around my age, dudes, jump off of bridges into lakes. And even though it is dangerous and you can die if you land the wrong way, it's like the adrenaline rush keeps you alive and escapes you from your perpetual boredom. However, for this specific challenge, I'm completely lost as to why it gained so much popularity.
That's really sad. And that's why I also inserted the clip with his father giving the background, because we'll hear these stories and we'll just assume, oh my gosh, it was just a kid, you know, somebody slow or whatever. But it's not always the case, because he was very ambitious. And sometimes, you know, social media is good for teaching stuff, just like how he learns how to do some things on YouTube. But then he fell victim to just trying to fit in and hear the toxic side of social media. And so it was unfortunate that this happened. So talk to your children and pray over your children. And we need to pray for our youth. But yeah, rest in peace, Joshua. And yeah, definitely got to mention how, you know, she's talking about crackhead generation. Well, drugs have definitely been a big influence in the music and even my generation as well as the younger generation.
Yo, Percocet, Miley Percocet, Percocet. Miley Percocets, rep the set, gotta rep the set, chase a chick, never chase a bitch.
So yeah, it has been getting more popular to talk about drugs, but you mean 166 million about a drug addict song?
It's drug addicts.
That is J. Cole's song, ATM, is a pretty good illustration of how it is with the drug culture, you know, especially with medical drugs. And yeah, it's pretty sad. I mean, it's a dope song, but yeah. So yeah, he did do a pretty good video on just the generational impact of how drugs impact everyone, from doing them to selling them and the paper chase mentality. So it definitely influences our pop culture. And like my daughter say,
like I said before, it's the crackheaded generation.
Oh, I tell you.
I'm still trying. Well, where is mine? I guess I'm using this one to do. Or am I?
So, yeah. As y'all can see, you know, we a trip, but we definitely always be talking. But just wanted to share in with that conversation and how that went. Yeah, I would have put even more information, but the video would be very long. So I'm going to try to work on shortening them. But yeah, it was very interesting just talking about, you know, the generations and parenting and social media. And especially on the parenting thing, I'm going to put some links in the description box. So make sure you check those out. You know, of course, there's some positive things, too, about each generation. So I would like to elaborate more on that. But hopefully you can pull some good information from what I did share on here. And, yeah, so if you want to see her doing her makeup and all of that, you can definitely go over to the link and check it out on the other channel, Adulche Cosmetic Designs, where you can see, you know, the full thing and the conversations and, of course, these edits, because I had a lot of fun editing these. It was quite hilarious, even though we talked about some serious things too, but it was definitely funny too. So if you want to go look at more details about that, but she did do a great job on her makeup. And yeah, so just letting y'all see that. Plus, you know, I have more details on what I did with my hair. And so y'all can see that over there. And yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and show y'all the before and after and how it went for the ceremony.
That last few paragraphs, I should mention the necessity of balance. How important that we continue to invest time. That we continue to invest time in our friends, family, and community.
Be here.
Hopefully talk kind of about it.
Sanaa Kanisha Andrea Idolce.
My head hurts.
Yeah, it's been a long day. Yeah, it's been a long day. And my hair turned all right, even though it rained on me.
At least it wasn't the way it was at that beach one time, because...
Whatever!
It was Struggle Bus City.
Anyways, in the comment section, feel free to say congratulations to my baby.
Gotta get that nostril action.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know we a mess over here.
Okay, so how you feel?
Exhausted.
What's your next plan?
Yeah, my next step is just to go to school to learn more about fashion and design. I applied to the Art Institute, and that's my plan.
Yes, Art Institute. I'm very excited for her going there. You know, I went to a university that had an art program, but I would have loved to gone to an art school. And I'm going to be supportive of her going. Because I'm an artist, you know, I never wanted to force my children to do that. You know, you want them to make their decision, because if they want to go a whole nother route, you know, I'm supportive of my children regardless of what they're going to want to do. We're definitely an artistic family, and she's grown up around it all the time, assisting on shoots and being around, you know, when I was working with Derek Blanks and just my own personal shoots and makeup and everything. But she wants to take the more fashion design route. And yeah, I think that's really cool. They also offer, you know, fashion marketing. That would help if she wants to do more of the business side of it versus actually hands-on sewing and stuff like that. So she wants to do fashion design. You know, we just see how it goes, and then she can always change it to fashion marketing or actually take some courses in fashion marketing. But yeah, I'm so excited for her. I think she's gonna do so well, and yeah, God is good.
That's where I'm gonna go. So, yeah.
Okay.
Well, y'all better understand, I'm tired.
Yeah, it's been a long night. They had a night graduation, so.
Mm-hmm. So if I see him in a funk mood, it is what it is.
I hear you. Well, you look gorgeous, baby.
Cheers. All right, y'all. So that is it for today. It's been a long day. Thank y'all for watching. Please wish my baby a congratulations for her graduation. She will be off to our institute to study fashion design. And I'm very excited for her, for her new venture. Thank you guys for watching. Please like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you can stay tuned for more content. And y'all have a good one.